And the third Workers Invitational Tournament has kicked off. Mayo versus Sindhya, and that was an attack by the Sindhya school in the Mayo team. Sindhya is still in possession. The game still revolving around the midfield. Possession with Mayo Bucket. No, it's again with Sindhya. It's a good start by Sindhya. And we've seen one attack already from them in the Mayo team. And Sindhya will keep possession. And that's a miss. Yes, managed to stop the ball. Good work by the defense. It's the first time you've seen Mayo come close to the 25-yard line of the Sindhya school. Sindhya in possession. And Sindhya will hold the ball.
So Sandeep, last time Leo had a very good goal. Good attack by Sindhya. Good save by the Leo keeper. Sandeep, last time Leo had a very dominant victory. And this time they seem to be missing a player.
Yeah, I think the player of the tournament was their captain last year, Shivram. I think the name is Shivram. He was very good along with the current captain. These two were very formidable. But you see, with each year, what we're seeing is that, you know, the level of the game on turf of each school has improved by leaps and bounds. We were watching the practice also, and I thought even the Valley Boys team has been very impressive during the practice.
No, absolutely, yeah. I think these teams are very much more used to playing on turf, and there is no custom model that. I think what's it's very early days here for the first few minutes of the open there's a lot more control by on the ground. And a lot more, they're playing a lot more regular game these types of benchmarks.
Obviously, the more you play and the more experience you get in playing on different surfaces, the game gets better. It's also very heartening to see the Sindhya school so far 60-40 position in favor of them. So Nalin, tell us about your experience, how you heard about the United for Hockey and how you decided to become a part of this club.
As you know, Sandeep, that's a miss of the Sandeep team. And
that's another attack by Sindhya school. So we've seen the first flashes of Mayo College, that they have made one attack. But at the moment, one would say that it's a good start by Sindhya school. They've been more attacking and they've been passing the ball around more. No doubt Mayo are the front runners, but so far, yes, now there's one attack from Mayo College, but it's been successfully handled by the Sindhya defense. I think we'll see more of those happening as soon as the game starts spreading on. And I think you simply have to start controlling the game at the whole field. So far, I think the main problem team is still trying to fight and say, oh, what a lovely ball that is, and what a save there from the Sindhi keeper. That is the first match of brilliance we've seen from Mayo, so that's the first touch of the keeper we've seen. Sindhi has gone to the knee twice, but the keeper is still not yet kept busy in the Mayo's team. Nalin, what are the conditions? Is it too early to start a game, or you think the kids can handle this sort of weather?
I think the boys can certainly handle this kind of weather. I'm not sure about the youth pitch, guys. It is hot, Sanjeev, and it's difficult from the pitch, but that's the nature of the game. The Mayo boys, I think, are just about warmed up and are now getting ready for this game.
And that's a good hit. Straight up to the Mayo College forward line, and we've seen number 5-6 dribble through three people again. That's a great pass, and that's the first penalty corner awarded to Mayo College. So that was a very swift move made by Mayo College. Tell me about penalty corners. I think it's completely changed the way the game has been, the game of hockey now, has it?
Absolutely, because the change in making it more exciting to get some more to get bigger scoreline in place. The game has gone so fast, and I think that you need to be able to make a lot of things.
Not just conversion, I think we need cheerleaders also for these penalty corners to make them more exciting for the crowd. And that's a good shot, and that's lovely defending by Sindhi. That ball has not had a flash, but it's still danger lurking in the Sindhi team, and that's another penalty corner. We've seen now that ever since starting in Denmark and all this coming, that's the time when penalty corners are given, that's the time when they can run actually at breaks. Earlier the problem used to be that how do you take a break when the game is on for about 35 minutes?
Good tackling by Sindhi there. The shot is blessed and fast counter attack by Sindhi as they beat the charge back into the team. Lovely ball. And that's a Mayo continuing to keep on running wisely. Good counter attack by Sindhi.
Malin, I think it's the midfield that will decide who will dominate the game. And so far, we've seen Sindhi boys very much after Mayo College. And that counter-attack was another example of how this team has matured. I remember the first time they came, it was a group of young boys and we didn't think much of them, but they showed in the game that if they had been given more time playing on this surface, they would have been very dangerous. But this time around, we're seeing that they have actually come after doing a lot of homework, so